I'll be introducing what Scarborough is, the history, what causes it, the symptoms, where it occurs, the treatments, interventions, the experiment, and summary. Scarborough is a histamine-toxicity syndrome, and it occurs after eating specific types of spoiled fish, and is one of the most frequent intoxications related to seafood. It was first described in 1799, and it was given the name Scarborough because of the belief that occurred to the family of Scarborough Day and Scarborough Society. And it's caused by eating contaminated fish, and fish that contains high levels of histamine, and if the fish is not placed in the appropriate temperatures. Some of the symptoms include facial flushing, sweating, rash, burning or peppery taste in the mouth, diarrhea, abdominal cramps, and nausea, which can be treated with over-the-counter medicine and go away hours. More severe symptoms include respiratory distress, swelling of the tongue, and blurred vision, which require serious medical attention. It occurs anywhere from basically anyone eats fish, and it was higher in Japan, the United States, and England, according to an article by Akbari Adigani in 2012. Doctors recommended was induced vomiting, oral charcoal. But before oral charcoal was given to a patient, it is recommended that the stomach is pumped to get rid of poison. And then hydramine, also known as Benadryl, and ranitidine, which is also known as Zantac. Some preventions. How a person can prevent Scarborough fish poisoning by keeping the fish properly refrigerated, which is below 40 degrees Fahrenheit, and stay away from food with strange smell or appearance. And how the government can prevent Scarborough fish poisoning is by inspecting fish at the production sites and giving more strict time limits and temperature controls during the commercial processing. The experiment that was done the levels of histamine was, and the objective was to evaluate the safety of different brands of canned tuna fish for high levels of histamine. And it was simple and a routine histamatic immune sorbent assay that had been compared with highly sensitive and accurate Fourier transformation cyclic voltammetry electrochemical method. And 30 different fish brands reflected from all different parts of Iran. And both methods that they compared had the same results. And higher levels of histamine was found in the fish from South Iran. And some things that were concluded from the experiment was the geographic location of where the fish was produced reflected histamine levels of the fish, and proper refrigeration prevents the poisoning, and inspection of fish at production sites can help reduce the levels, and ALSA and chlorine transformation cyclic voltammetry electrochemical method are very effective for taking out poison. And summary is, off
have two questions. You said they were radishes. What do they look like? Like, are they red? Or...
just like a normal radish. It's red and itchy.
And my second question is, you said if you need to seek medical attention, you said that they first pump your stomach. How would you stomach
that? Can you repeat
that? I said, you said in your housing that when you seek medical attention, first they pump your stomach. How is